At the outset, I would like to thank the TCT Scientific Committee and the organizers for giving us this opportunity and accepting and our transcatheter novel aortic valve. And today we'll be showing a case in box of this novel transcatheter balloon expandable aortic valve implantation. So transcatheter heart valve aortic valve case presentation. So I have nothing to disclose. So this patient is a 76-year-old gentleman with diagnosis of symptomatic severe aortic stenosis, which has been progressive over past 1 year. Presently, he is in NYHA class 3 to class 4 symptoms, as he was admitted a week ago in class 4 heart failure. Echo showed sclerodegenerative tricuspid aortic stenosis with an EF of 50%. He also has moderate pulmonary disease and has a non-obstructive coronary artery disease. His STS score is 4.8% for mortality, which puts him into intermediate risk category for an open AVR. One of the enrollment criteria for the study of the first-in-man transcatheter heart valve is STS score of more than 4. So this patient fulfills the criteria to be enrolled into this study. This is a transthoracic assessment, and as you can clearly see, it's a tricuspid valve with a velocity of 5.5 meters per second, peak gradient of 123 millimeters of mercury, mean gradient of 67 millimeters of mercury, aortic valve area of 0.3 centimeters square, mild AR, no mitral regurgitation, ejection fraction of 50%, annular diameter of 20 millimeters, and right ventricular systolic pressure of 32 millimeters of mercury. So this is the CT scan analysis, and as everybody is aware of it, that CT scan is mandatory to assess and plan a transcatheter aortic valve implantation. The area of the annulus is 418 millimeters square with good coronary, adequate coronary height. The diameter at the level of annulus, the minimal diameter is 20, the maximal diameter is 25. This is going to help us to select a pre-dilatation balloon, and we plan to use a 20 millimeter balloon. Again, adequate dimensions. Coronary heights are good. This is, we are looking at the calcification. Most of the calcification is at the leaflet, but there is some calcification even in the LV outflow tract. As you can see, a chunk of calcium beneath the left coronary sinus. This is the CT scan derived deployment angles to determine our coplanar view. So this system is compatible with a 14 French Python sheath or a 22 French sheath. This is a 22 French system when it is loaded inside a sheath. And here you can see the femoral, the common iliac, external iliac dimensions are more than 7 to 7.5 mm. This is a sizing chart of the patient, of the valve. This valve is sized based on the area. And if you look at the sizing chart, this patient qualifies for a 23 millimeter transcatheter aortic valve, which is almost no oversize if you look at the area derived diameter of the patient, of the annulus. This is a design of the Myval balloon expandable transcatheter heart valve. This is a delivery system. It is directly crimped over a balloon. This is the delivery catheter again. It is the navigator transcatheter heart valve delivery system. It can be torqued to almost 130 to 160 to 180 degree over itself. This is a Python sheath, which is an expandable introducer sheath. So let us look at the echo. Yeah, so if you look at the transthoracic echocardiogram, this is a parasternal long axis view. And you can clearly see thickened and calcified leaflets with good LV contractility. You can see some mild aortic regurgitation. Four chamber view again showing good LV contractility, LV concentric hypertrophy. So these are the gradients across the aortic valve. Here you can see a mean gradient of 67 millimeters of mercury, peak gradient of 123, velocity of 5.5 meter per second. So the aortic valve area derived by the continuity equation is 0.39 centimeters square, which clearly shows that it is critical aortic stenosis, mild aortic regurgitation, no mitral regurgitation, good contractility. The other important thing, we're looking at the baseline pericardial effusion. There is no baseline pericardial effusion. Two chamber view. So I think we are all set here. We'll be doing a transfemoral, totally percutaneous transcatheter aortic valve implantation. We already have, let's focus on the groin. So we have a 5 French sheath in the left femoral artery. We have a 6 French sheath in the left femoral vein. Now we'll be taking the puncture on the right side. So as on the CT scan, we already know that the bifurcation is low. So we'll be using a micropuncture. So micropuncture is a 22 gauge needle with an 018 wire. And this is a 4 French sheath. So we'll try take an axis. We'll do a femoral angiogram after that. So this is a micropuncture sheath in the right common femoral artery. We'll take a femoral angiogram. Show us down. Good, good. Go RAO. Good. IA down. So I think that's a good puncture. We are in the middle of the common femoral artery. Next we'll put our, give us a long wire please. Teflon wire. Next is, we'll be needing a 7F sheath, a pigtail and a temporary pacemaker. Okay. This comes out. Let us see. We leave the wire in place to make sure there's no bleeding going on. So we'll put a 12 French sheath. Show us down groin. Yeah, follow the sheath. Okay. Good. Okay. Still leave the wire in place. Flush, please. Looks better now. We are all set here. Let's put a pigtail from the left side. So put a balloon balloon tip pacemaker from the left side. Okay, balloon down. So it's very important for us to really identify the person who is going to control the pacing.
So can I check the pacing?
Yeah, sure. Check pace at 80. Yeah. Threshold of 1.
Threshold of 1.
Good, good. That's good. Backup rate of 50.
Okay, backup rate of 50.
And threshold you can increase to maximum. So you can see how the valve is, the catheter is bobbing. Can you mag up a little? Okay. Come RAO please.
Yeah.
So that's our AR2 catheter. Give me a flush. So we'll be using a pre-dilating 20mm balloon. Yeah, good. So let us focus on the hemodynamics. So here you can see the LV pressure is 226 with a diastolic pressure of almost 10. The aortic pressure is 174 over 66. And we clearly have severe aortic stenosis. The other important thing which we look at it is the aortic diastolic pressure so that we remember when we are comparing at the post-procedure results. So the wire which I have is an implant extra stiff wire. I'm going to shape it. So how much was the aortic valve area? 0.3. So this is going to go under fluoroscopy. We just kind of slowly, slowly, slowly. Slowly. All right, so there was almost no resistance. So our sheath is in. So we have crossed the LV. We have our implants extra stiff wire into the LV. Now we're going with a 20 millimeter balloon. Pace at 160. Okay, inflate. Deflate. That's okay. Yeah, stop pacing. Look at the pericardium. Yeah, we're okay. Can we have the valve, please?
Yes.
We're looking at the pericardium to make sure there's nothing going wrong. So we'll do a fluoro of the valve here.
Please confirm the position.
So definitely, that's a very important thing. The orientation, you can see the skirt is towards the blue end of the delivery catheter. It is ventricular. Okay, so we'll take a cine here. So I think it is well mounted right in the center. Okay, we remove the stillet. Time to go in with the valve. Change the injection settings for 10 for 10.
Yeah, ready, sir.
So the command will be exactly like this. Begin pacing at 160. Close now, close.
Yeah.
Close now. Okay, just a little. Okay. So let us come to the same view. LAO 18, 0 cranial caudal.
Yeah.
So what we're going to do is we'll torque it here.
Isko rotate
karna. Yeah, we'll rotate it here so that it comes over the arch. Mag down. So we're going to, it's just a very user friendly. Show us the wire also. We can torque it. We can torque it. And then it's going to come over. Show us the wire tip also. We can torque it here. Nice. Show us the wire tip, please.
Yeah, looks okay.
Yeah, looks okay. There's a lot of resistance here at the arch. So we're going to torque it more. Okay, so we got, so I think this is the advantage. Mag up a little. Mag up, yes. So we're going to cross. Okay, focus on the valve here. So we're going to get enter. We're going to enter here. Okay, fluoro save. Fast. Inject. Yeah. So what we're looking at here, we're planning to aim at is 80% aortic and 20% ventricular. So here, if you can, I'm just going to go on cine here. If you can see, there are certain bands, a big band and then a row. We're trying to aim somewhere in the upper part of the second row and just beneath the middle marker. So what we'll do is, we'll pace here at 140. Okay. Inject. Inject. Okay, stop pacing. So let us review this pace. Freeze. So if you look at this picture, what I'm looking at is, I think we are almost 70-30. We are 70% aortic and almost 30% ventricular. Mm-hmm. And we're almost in the, I think to me it looks like a good position to start. I think it looks very good position to start. All right, let's take one more picture. Okay, inject. I think it's good. It looks good to me. Okay. Yeah. Okay, so begin pacing at 160. Yeah, 160. 160. Pressure slow. Begin inflation. Begin inflation. Begin inflation. Inflate, 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 inflate. Fully inflate, fully inflate. Fully inflate 1001 to 1002, 1003, 1004. Deflate, 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 deflate. Stop pacing, please. Pigtail out. Hemant, look at the pericardium. This balloon also comes out. Hemant, look at the pericardium here. Give some, yeah, pace. That's good. Everything looks good. Let it recover. Let everything come back. Let us all calm down here. Let us pace at 60, please. Pace at 60. Let us see what is happening. Just pace at 60. Yeah, just pace at 60 for a minute. Yeah, give me 1 second. Okay. Stop pacing here for a minute. Yeah, stop pacing. Good. Let the sinus rhythm come back. Okay. Hemant, how does the LV look? Show us some AR. Let us... Okay, look at the echo. Let us look at the gradients.
Gradient is 7.
You see any AR there? Do you see any AR, Hemant?
No AR.
No AR, all right. Okay, so what we'll do is we'll take an aortogram here. So I think a wire is almost out. But what we'll do is we'll still take an aortogram. Where's the pigtail? Pigtail is out. So let us look at the aortic diastolic pressure. This is what I was saying. Aortic diastolic pressure is almost 62.
62.
No, I mean, if we are not satisfied with the AR, we can always post-dilate. The reason, remember, we use a 26 valve and we underfill it by 2 cc's. So this is the echo. So here we have a mean gradient of 5, peak gradient of 10, velocity of 1.5. Show us some AR, Hemant. Find your worst view. Show us some AR. So the other reason could, because of that, for that mild AR which we see on the cine is because the wire is still there in the valve. So let us do one thing, let us come out with the catheter, let us put our pigtail down, do some hemodynamic measurement. The reason is, we have good gradient, there's almost no gradients on echo, and the wire is, valve is well in place, there's nothing in the coronary arteries, both of them are flowing. So I think if everybody agrees, we need not cross the valve again.
Perfect.
All right. Stop the pacemaker. Yeah, right. All right. So I think that's a very good position.
Sinus rhythm.
Yeah. Nothing on the echocardiogram. No aortic regurgitation. So no gradients. So what we'll do is, these are our proglides. We identify which is the first, which is the second. So I've identified this is the first. So Dr. Sanjeev, do you want to hold the mag down? 48. Go to DSA. Show us down. Show us the femoral head. Okay. So we deployed three proglides, and you can see if almost there is no.
There is no ooze.
Yeah, slight ooze, which is subcutaneous. Inject. All right. So we can see there is almost no groin complication, no bleed, blood vessel complication. You can see a good hemostasis at the common femoral artery, nothing happening at the common iliac, external iliac artery. And I think that's a successful proglide deployment. There's no pinching, absolutely no pinching. Yeah. So let us focus on the groin here, IA above, IA up, using three proglides, no extravasation at all. And I think that was a successful transcatheter balloon expandable aortic valve by using a percutaneous approach from the right common femoral artery using three proglides, and no perivalvular leak at the end, no gradients, good LV functions, no pericardial effusion, no groin complications, and it was a successful transcatheter aortic valve. I would like to thank the scientific committee of TCT for giving me this opportunity to present a novel transcatheter aortic valve implantation. Thank you very much.